Welcome to POCUS Geek. I'm Jared Marks, and in this video we're going to talk about a right ureteral vesicular stone with some mild hydronephrosis in a patient. This is a great study. I love using renal ultrasound to diagnose ureterolithiasis. Sometimes we can see that stone. Sometimes we're able to make this diagnosis based off of data such as hematuria, patient symptoms and presentation, and hydronephrosis, which really adds to that data to say, yes, this is a ureterolithiasis. I am not of the opinion that every kidney stone or ureterolithiasis needs a CT, and I think that we can diagnose this and use ultrasound first. In fact, there are some societies to say that this is the first study that should be performed in suspected ureterolithiasis, and also that it is safe and effective way to diagnose that. So we're going to start. This is a patient, as I've told you already, had right ureterolithiasis, but I like to always start imaging with their non-affected side. So if they have right-sided pain, right-sided flank pain, I'm going to look at the left kidney first. However, if they have left-sided flank pain, I'm going to look at the right. This just gives me a chance to evaluate the kidney and see what their normal looks like, and allows me to better understand what to expect. And I say that most kidneys are going to look the same. However, sometimes we can have some prominent vasculature in the area, and that can be confused for hydronephrosis. Typically, they're going to have the same thing on both sides if they have that prominent vasculature, but it does allow me to compare those. So what we're going to see here, this is somewhat of a limited view because we do have a rib shadow that is right here and casting it down over that kidney, and that can limit this evaluation. So we do want to get supplemental views. If you haven't watched the anatomy, the sonographic anatomy lecture, you can click on this card up here and in the corner and go watch that. We want to see the entire capsule of the kidney, evaluate the entire thing. On this one, it's a little limited, but enough to help us understand how to diagnose hydronephrosis and ureterolithiasis. So we're going to move that probe just a little bit to get a better view, again, of the kidney. And subsequently, we're going to pay attention to the renal pelvis. Now, ideally, we're going to see the renal pelvis extend from here all the way out to the medial capsule. In this view, we don't have it, but that would be ideal to make sure we're in the right plane for that renal pelvis. Now, when we look at the kidney in a short axis, we again are going to see the kidneys here, and the renal pelvis this time does come in contact with the medial portion, which helps us to be able to make sure that we're in the right plane. So right through here, we can still see that that is hyperechoic and connecting with that medial capsule. Now, when we switch to the right kidney, we start to see we're in the long axis. Now, the difficulty here is, again, instead of a rib shadow this time, we have some bowel gas, and that's causing dirty shadowing through here. So we aren't seeing that pull of the kidney, and we'd want to make sure to see that at some point if we could. Unfortunately, in this images, we don't have that, but we can see where the kidney is, and then we can see that renal pelvis. Now, the renal pelvis on this is does have hydronephrosis, and we see that by this inner area, which is hypoechoic to anechoic compared to the other side. Now, if we think that this is a vessel and are concerned that that's the case, we can always throw color Doppler over it as we do in this example. And again, we're going to see that right through here is going to be that hydronephrosis, and that we see the vasculature around it. If that was a vessel, we would expect to see that light up with red and blue tones, as we see here demonstrating the vasculature. We can then go on to evaluate in a short axis. Right here we see the kidney again, and we see the renal pelvis come into view circled in red, and then right in the middle in yellow we do see a mild amount of hydronephrosis. I'm going to back up just a little bit. When we look at this hydronephrosis, something to pay attention to is that it is coming into the renal pelvis, but we can still appreciate other parts of the renal pelvis. That means that this is mild. Once we get out to the calyces, we're going to be talking about moderate hydronephrosis. And what I mean is, when we look out into this area, we still see white, and that's still renal pelvis. If that is obliterated, then that would mean that we're at least to moderate hydronephrosis. Whereas through right here, we do have our hydronephrosis right there. And I'll take that off so you can see that better. One thing to note here that we do have, or likely have, and it's a little bit better in dynamic scanning, but right here it looks like there's a likely stone and maybe another one here. Stones don't usually cast shadows in the kidneys like they do for cholelithiasis, and can be seen. They will just be hyperechoic areas, usually near the renal pyramids or calyces, and will be a hyperechoic region and visible that way. And again, if we'd like to, we can put color Doppler on this in the short axis and appreciate that there is no flow within that area of hydronephrosis, which is best seen right through here. And then lastly, we're going to jump down to the bladder. I like to look for the bladder first in a long axis. I think it's easier to find because we can first identify our pubic bone. We can place the probe just superior to that with the probe marker towards the head. We can appreciate that this is the pubic bone because it has shadowing through here. And then we're able to look at the bladder a little bit more. Now you'll fan right to left through the bladder and just evaluate for any findings within the bladder itself. And then I like to go to a short axis view with the probe marker to the patient's right. What we see in this image here though is we can see the ureter is actually dilated. We see that anechoic area or hypoechoic area, and then this bright object within it, this hyperechoic structure, and that is a ureterolithiasis. A trick that you can do is once you find that, you can throw color over it. This will give you what's called twinkle artifact, and most of the time it will have a comet tail come down through here and give some further artifact down there. And this is a ring down artifact that we can find with a ureterolithiasis and helps us diagnose this. So this stone is located at the UVJ, just about to enter the bladder, hopefully for the patient. And so what we see here is we can see with the arrow, I like to find the ureters first and then fan proximally to identify the stone, but we can see the ureter here right where the yellow arrow is. We'll see that black area connecting with the bladder. And then just proximal to that, as we fan superior, we'll see the ureterolithiasis with the green arrow. When we do see this, we can then use a measure or calipers button on our machine to get an estimated size of that stone and determine from that any treatments that may be needed and the likelihood of that stone to pass spontaneously. I hope that you found that educational, and if you find this educational content useful, feel free to check out some of the other videos or subscribe to our content. You can, and if you have questions about this, feel free to reach out to me at pocusgeek@gmail.com.